Hey everyone, today's video is all about converting Procreate illustrations and patterns like mine into vector files using Adobe Illustrator. Now some of you might be wondering why bother. The truth is Procreate's raster files are fantastic for illustrations and patterns even if you plan to license them, but there might be a client who specifically needs a vector pattern. This is where knowing how to convert your files comes in handy. Vector patterns have a huge advantage. They can be scaled up without losing quality, unlike raster files. Now that's a game changer. So let's dive in and see how easy this process can be. Okay, let's start with creating a new canvas. So I'm going to click on the plus sign and I'm going to select a 3000 by 3000 pixel canvas, or you can just click here on the plus and type in 3000 by 3000 and then click on create. And I'm going to use my pattern template here called Ogee to create a template where I'm going to draw my floral pattern. And if you want to learn how to create one of those then yourself, just click the link below and you can take the tutorial that I have for that. So I'm going to click in here and then click on the arrow and fit to canvas. Now this is just a guide, so I'm going to turn down the opacity and also I'm going to lock it. And then I'm going to create another layer and just put that below the guide. And now I'm going to use the monoline brush, which is in the calligraphy library. And that is a smooth brush that you can use, which I find works really well when you go to vectorize in Adobe Illustrator. And I'm going to create an abstract floral design inside of this template here. So I'm using this color palette here with just blue and yellow, and you can download that as well. The link is below. I'm going to create my colors on different layers, so I'm going to keep them all on their own layers, which will be handy later on when we vectorize it. And I'm creating a kind of a tulip shape flower here. And then I can just fill that color in. Going to go back to my navy blue layer here and add some more details to the flowers. I might just move these up a little bit. And on another layer, I'm just going to add some little leaves with the yellow. And if I drag the color in and then click on continue filling, I can add the color to each of those leaves. And then I'm going to create another layer. Actually, no, I'm not. I'm just going to put the yellow below the navy and then use the navy layer to add some branches. I'm not liking the angle of that one, so on my yellow layer, I'm just going to use the selection tool and circle around there, then click on the dot. Now if I click the arrow here, I can just move it to fit the angle better. And then I can put my branch on there. Okay, I'm happy with that. So the next thing I want to do is export this and take it into Adobe Illustrator on my computer. Now to do that, I'm going to turn off the guide. I'm going to remove that layer, it's an empty layer. And I'm also going to turn off the background. So what we want to do is export these three layers. To do that, I'm going to go to the wrench action tool and click on share, and then click on PNG files, and this will export each layer as a PNG file. And I'm just going to airdrop it to my MacBook. Okay, I've opened up Illustrator and I'm going to create a new file. And I'm just going to do a 10 by 10 inch 300 dpi. And I have my three layers here. So I'm just going to grab each of those and just drag them onto the artboard. And we'll drag them into the middle here. And we are going to image trace each layer. So if you look down here in the layers panel, we've got the three layers. So if we just start with the light blue and then go to the image trace icon here, if you can't see that, go up to window and then select image trace. And then you want to select this one here called three colors. I'm then going to just change, open up the advanced section here and select ignore white. Make sure preview is on. And I'm also just going to change the color, number of colors to 2. And I also want to save this as a preset so that I don't have to keep putting in the details each time. So if I go to the little icon on the right here, go save as a new preset, and let's name this Procreate 2 colors. And that has now image traced. We want to expand it. So now it's an isolated vector. And let's do that for each of the layers that we've got here. So my next layer is the yellow. If I go to the preset and then click on Procreate 2 colors and then click expand, and then for the last one do the same and then expand. And you may have noticed that the layers are in reverse, so I'm just going to drag the navy blue to the top to put it back on top. So now what I want to do is create a quick pattern with this. So I'm going to grab all of those and I'm going to go to Object, Pattern, Make. And then in the tile type, I'm going to select Hex by Column. And I quite like that, but I actually want to move a few things here and actually fill in some of these gaps. So I'm going to dim the outer tiles, so maybe 50%, just so I know that I'm working on this inner part here. And then if I ungroup everything, that means I can then select individual pieces. And I'm just going to hold down the Option key and click and drag this to create another leaf. And then the same with these, I'm going to ungroup them. And I'm going to select these two here as one and then hold down the Option key to copy, and then we can create another little leaf. And I might actually group those as well. So if I right click and click on group, or you could do Command plus G. And then I can rotate these and put them in a position. I'm just going to keep doing that until I can fill these gaps. Okay, I'm happy with that. Now if I click on done, that has now added it to my swatches panel over here. So if I move this over and grab the rectangle tool, drag that out, and then click on the pattern that we just created, and it's put it in there. Now I'm going to duplicate that by just dragging that down to the bottom there, and then selecting the bottom one and giving that a white background. And now you can see it's given it a nice background. And then if I just right click this and transform, and then transform the scale, we can change the scale down and just need to make sure that transform objects is turned off, and that way it just transforms the pattern, not the actual element. And there you can see a lovely vector pattern, and this can be scaled up or down and it's not going to lose any quality. Now if you wanted to export this pattern out to, say, then use on a print-on-demand website such as Spoonflower, the way I would do that is, if I just move that over, if we drag the pattern from the swatches onto here, that is the repeat tile there. And now if you look carefully, this inner one here, this inner rectangle is the repeating tile. So what I will do is I'm just going to select it by just dragging my mouse over it, and we just want to select that inner rectangle. So I'm just going to select A on the keyboard, let go of that, and then reselect just the rectangle. And then if I go to Object, Artboards, Convert to Artboards, that has now made that repeating tile a artboard, so we can export it. I also want to add a background, so I'm going to grab the rectangle and just create a white background, and we want to make sure that's in that group. So I'm dragging it into the group here that is this repeating tile, and making sure that the background is at the back. And now that is artboard number 2, so we can go to File, Export As. And then if I select Use Artboard and make sure that the range says number 2, and I'm going to export that as a JPEG. Let's give it a name, Blue Floral Pattern. And I'll keep all of that as it is and then click OK. And that has exported the repeating tile. You could then now upload that to Spoonflower. So I'm just going to select the file, upload it, and there it is there. We could add it to a collection, give it a name, give it some tags, and then obviously it is going to be rendered onto some products. So let's go and have a quick look at those. So now we've got the pattern on wallpaper, on kitchen and dining ware, bedding, living and decor, and then fabric. All right, everyone, that's it. You should now be able to easily convert your Procreate illustrations and patterns into vector files using Adobe Illustrator. Remember, vector graphics offer that amazing benefit of endless scalability without sacrificing quality. If you have any questions or suggestions for other tutorials, please pop them in the comments below. If you want to learn more about creating patterns in Procreate on the iPad, I suggest you take a look at this playlist here.